Hello and welcome to a Star Citizen Alpha 3.18 State of the Game. CIG employees have started to come back to the office now from their holidays, and you can expect them to be actively making updates again next week. That said, they've actually pushed out a new PTU patch already, and I want to talk about that and the state of the 3.18 PTU. So, we've got a 3.18 patch, 3.18.0U, and that's seen some additional work, some additional stability improvements, and a load of bug fixes. But there's still a good few major blockers for that patch. It's still Wave 1, so only Evocardi Concierge, RSI subscribers, and some very active Issue Council users have access. We can expect an open PTU, in my opinion, next week most likely, and live by the end of the month is the plan from CIG. It's been a bit of a bumpy road with 3.18. It's seen a variety of delays and problems with that persistent entity streaming sort of stuff. We knew that was going to happen to some extent, but obviously I didn't expect the open PTU to be pushed back into January as well. When we see that open PTU as well, we should see Cloud Imperium open up more servers as well, because at the moment it's just US-based servers and a limited amount of them at that, which is causing its own set of issues, but is also providing very useful data collection and bug fixing for Cloud Imperium apparently. So in that latest 3.18.0U PTU patch, there's been some changes. They removed the nearby drop limit on inventory items, so you can pile and stack items a lot more. This is obviously sensible to be able to test and use the persistent entity streaming stuff that is in 3.18, but there could certainly be some server or performance issues when too many items are around. Testing is required, and obviously we're going to see that tested a lot more once it opens up to open PTU. They slightly raised the Corsair landing height, extended ramp slightly further, and ramp angle is slightly steeper. They tweaked the Reclaimer lift speed to help prevent damage. They updated the Salvage Filler Station to allow crafting of multiple items. So this is actually, it's quite a small little change, but it has huge implications for 3.18 and beyond. So that crafting update is now available in the Vulture and Reclaimer. You can craft multi-tools and the tractor and salvage attachments as well using salvaged material, which the ship can collect, which is incredibly useful as you need a tractor beam to do any form of meaningful salvage in a ship, because you need to move the 1SU boxes and the filler stations generate. You have to move those boxes into the actual cargo grid of the ship. Otherwise, you have like a blocked door that the actual filler station's blocked, and then you have no way of actually harvesting any more salvage because it can't dispense it. It was a terrible design flaw of those ships. Or you could argue, well, actually, they want salvage to be a lot more hands-on. Crafting, though, that's exciting. The current implementation there is only temporary, apparently. I do think that Cloud Imperium could run with that and evolve it, though, given enough celebration of the mechanic. And we do know there's going to be crafting in Star Citizen and expect it a more full-throated experience with that. But it's really cool that they are looking at it now, even if it is just a sort of temporary measure. What else? There was also a physics polish pass, though I haven't noticed anything generally with that. There was a ton of other fixes, though, hopefully solving the following issues. Players falling through elevators, joining a new shard can get you stuck in the loading screen. Scanning not showing advanced statistics and details, the Vehicle Manager app taking several minutes to load a ship loadout, clients stalling when entering ASOP Terminal's rendering range, ships abandoned on planets not appearing on ASOP Terminals, ASOP consoles showing information of another player, the grenade launcher does no damage and has no force reactions, inventory moval function is failing to move armor, restricted area violations trigger too soon at Lawville, while flying in atmosphere the Vulture will constantly input a downward pitch, players are unable to log out of the constellation beds while under attack and with other players aboard, Corsair LOD issues on the right VTOL engine, salvage beam persisting upon exiting and re-entering a seat, the merge between rivers and lakes is currently very harsh as a transition, with terrain flickering in and out at the location, not sure if that's also a bit of Zed fighting, but it should be fixed. River water can be seen floating above the terrain at various mountaintops, the rear interior ramp of the Cutlass Red and Blue can be locked with player stuck outside the ship. The word pressure on the Corsair's airlock was spelled incorrectly. Players exploiting the salvage elevator geometry to clip into the ship via EVA. After firing the missiles on a Cyclone MT, players were not able to fire the main cannon. If a player abandons or topples over the Grey Cat on the racetrack, they are not cleaned up and do not respawn at the race pit. The Stonebug Harvestable is missing its shuffling moving legs animation, so Stonebugs are effectively a creature in game, but they are just little harvestables. Vanguard Sentinel lower bunk has no atmosphere. Dakari Pod used the same model as the Stonebug shell. The 890 jump hangar elevator gravity is missing, and they also fixed 15 client crashes, 4 server crashes, and a server deadlock. There's actually quite a lot of fixes there that are very, very, very good for the game, making Alpha 3.18 on this sort of iteration significantly more playable. However, there is still a known issue set that Cloud Imperium are trying to work through. Refuel, repair, and rearm services unavailable when landed. Not great if you want to, you know, do any of those services with your ship, which you will want to do. Items appear to not be removed from the player's inventory when they sell them. So again, that's a little bit weird. Walking on hills near Whistler's Crypt can potentially kill or wound players. Equipped gear can be lost when a player dies in an armistice zone. Elevator doors open amid transit. The Merlin doesn't undock from the Constellation. The Mercury Star Runner only loads 6 SU of cargo. What have they done to my beautiful boy? The Reclaimer has no rear elevator interaction. Vehicles don't take damage when hit at certain parts of their health. So this is a desync problem. It doesn't happen all the time, but it can happen, and it's pretty annoying. Loot boxes loading indefinitely. Elevators and trams jittery during transit of players. That's not great because it sort of really breaks immersion when they do weird stuff, elevators and trams, but at least they get you there. It is possible for the vehicle HUD to vanish for the player during flight and combat. Probably the worst bug in 3.18 in my opinion. Multi-tool variants display healing info regardless of attachments. There are some NPC spawning issues at a couple of missions. Loot boxes will disappear on approach after opening as well, so streaming issue there. Now, issues with the HUD vanishing, they are really bad. It really breaks the game when that happens, and for me, that is by far the worst bug in 3.18 currently. There's desync and damage for like hitting ships, that could be annoying, but doesn't affect me that much. I'm not doing competitive PvP or anything. I'm just trying to shoot stuff, and my hits still land for the most part. Inventory and interaction issues can break the game sometimes, which is certainly not ideal. You do need that stuff to be sort of really, really ironed by now. Elevators and trams, general transit, that works so much better at the moment than previous 3.18 builds. So it is a mixed bag when it comes to general game sort of accessibility. Clan Imperium really need to solve most of those issues ASAP, especially before a live build. And they've given themselves a load of extra time by saying it's planned for the end of January. 3.18 and persistent entity streaming has been a bit of a bumpy road, but there is a huge amount of genuinely great gameplay in 3.18. There is just a huge amount of cool stuff to do. Salvage gameplay, boarding and looting with soft destruction, proper piracy, a load more points of interest and missions to do, a little bit of crafting, loads of racing for people that are interested in racing. And if you're not interested in racing, you can watch them or just go to the points of interest. Loads of race courses. A ton of lore changes and updates to prisons and security post Korea. I'm really looking forward to playing through a load of the Orison platform missions as well. A load of those FPS combat missions that I can do at smaller scale than something like the Siege of Orison, where actually I'm fully in control of that mission now. We're going to really do a load of content on the various new points of interest and those mission sort of areas. And once 3.18 is a bit more stable, you'll see Zin and I plowing through a load of those missions and different types of gameplay, because 3.18 really does allow you to immerse yourself in the game like never before. But I'm really interested to know what you think. That's it for your state of the game 3.18 today. But what do you think? Have you been playing the latest 3.18 patch? Have you had your most annoying bugs fixed? Are you having issues with your HUDs? Do you expect the open PTU for next week? Whatever your thoughts, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. It's a new year, time for resolutions, a brighter future. I'll make myself better each day. Or I could just stay at home and play computer games. But what if someone steals my house or bank while I'm otherwise preoccupied on the internet? NordVPN.com/boardgamer. It's probably the best VPN deal of 2023 already. Not only does it provide security, anonymity, and accessibility on the interwebs, but I haven't heard of anyone with NordVPN having their house stolen. Thanks, NordVPN. Now no one will know what type of degenerate anime I watch. Get NordVPN, you filthy animal. You deserve it. Every month we have a ship giveaway. For January, we are giving away an Argo Raft, the reinforced advanced freight transport ship, a dedicated cargo hauler that should see some additional gameplay in 2023. This also comes with a Star Citizen game package and lifetime insurance. All you need to do to be in for a chance of winning that is comment on any of my videos made during the month. More details in the description below. If you'd like to further support the channel, then please consider becoming a YouTube member with the join button under my videos. You could even become a Patreon. There's links below to that. But liking, subscribing, commenting goes a huge way to help the channel grow. Thanks so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the verse.